eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are just about ready with the game between Epsilon and not Na'Vi, but Titan instead. It's French on French action, and it's going to be pretty sick here on Mirage for the SLTV Starseries Season 10. Still waiting for everyone to join, so we should be good to go in, I don't know, a couple of minutes, I think. You're at Room on Fire, of course. So thank you very much for tuning in and joining us here. This is going to be an interesting match. I mean, how long has it been since we've really caught any Titan action here, guys?
Seems like ages. Since 2 weeks ago? When we got to do the, when Titan played in the Case King of the Hill on Wednesday.
Right, yeah.
At least I think that's the last time I remember watching Titan play.
It was, and the improvement was pretty obvious, I think, from the Titan of, pre-Copenhagen games. But there were still some mistakes, and I think the couple of weeks it's been since that tournament, I think it's actually enough time that they could have improved quite massively here.
Well, we hope.
Real quick, shout outs to Screen for his name.
What is Screen?
Sick manga.
Hunter x Hunter.
Damn straight, man. He's got good taste. He's got good taste.
Okay then. I don't know what that is, but
I'll The chat might know, but it's a dope manga. Really good.
Your references are out of control. Everybody knows that, Sam.
Oh, yeah, I'm just saying. Anders lives under a rock, I guess.
Yeah.
I do. I actually just have no idea. You got to remember, I'm really old as well, so if it didn't happen in the mid-90s, I probably don't remember anyway. I just don't know what it is.
It did happen in the mid-90s, actually. Apart from Dragon Ball, that was pretty much my first big manga that I got into and loved.
All right, fair
enough. I was 12, 13 when I started reading that.
So back in the 70s.
Yeah, back in the 70s, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll have to brush up or something. I'll see if I can figure something out. Now, look, this game is going to be, I think, highly, highly unpredictable. First of all, because Epsilon, as we've just seen, is a slightly unpredictable team. I think there's every chance, actually, they can come right back on this map and just play twice as good, basically, as they did on Dust 2. Because if they just make, this is where it becomes really frustrating. If the mistakes Epsilon made were some that are really, really hard to iron out, I'd be like, yeah, well, you know, all right, it's going to take a couple of weeks before they get, you know, some of those things down. But the mistakes they make were actually pretty easy to avoid. So if they just avoid them this game, they're probably going to be, you know, 20, 40, whatever, 50% better than they were in the other game.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And I guess it also remains to see if we're going to see the Titan we hope to see, or if we're going to see Circus Titan because of this. A day of Circus Counter-Strike, really.
It could be. I mean, the thing is that Epsilon are obviously going to have Titan mapped out pretty well.
Yeah, that's
also because, you know, Shoxi is a dirty trader. So, you know, they may have that edge going for him here, Epsilon. Shoxi is definitely going to know exactly what Titan are up to on Mirage.
Yeah, that's true. Obviously, Shoxi was replaced on that team by Kenny, who was previously on the team as well. So it's a bit of a comeback for Kenny. I don't know what to make of it. I mean, it's going to be a lot of interesting matchups here. It's also, I mean, Kenny versus FXGO is going to be interesting, I think.
Then again, Titan will have changed up quite a bit of their play style due to Kenny joining them. There was a team that we saw actually have a really bumpy start when Kenny first joined up because of how much they actually had to change to be able to fit him up in the roster. So not too sure how valuable Shoxi's information is going to be as far as, you know, how much the team has stayed the same and how much it's changed since his departure.
Maybe they can use it against him.
Well, I think actually Titan are looking more like the Titan pre-Shoxi. So
map control.
Well, in that sense, they're already kind of mapped out for most teams. So, and I think that also that's partly why they've been having so much trouble. And I guess it's down to see if they're able to sort that out before G3 and Gamescom. If they're actually going to have a shot at doing anything.
Well, they got through the qualifiers pretty easily. So there is that for Gamescom.
But yeah, that is to be expected from a team like that. And though, regardless of how big of a slump they are in, you can't really have a major without Titan in it.
Just imagine.
Similar to Na'Vi, really. I mean, it would have been a real shame if Na'Vi didn't make it.
Yeah, I agree. Look, guys, the knife round is coming up right here. Just waiting for Kiyoshima to man up and take the fight against the other Frenchman, and we should be good to go. But look, welcome to the stream, everyone. This is the SLTV Starseries Season 10 Room on Fire, presenting to you Titan versus Epsilon. It's going to be a best-of-one game on Mirage. I'm Andy's with me, Assembler and Vendetta, of course. Remember, guys, to subscribe to the channel if you want to help us out, or click the follow button. We're almost actually at 155,000, so the channel is growing at a really incredible rate these past couple of days, and we really appreciate it a whole lot. So big thanks to all of you for doing that. And also click the links at the bottom of the stream. There's a Facebook raffle going on. There's also a cool YouTube video with a bit of a commercial that Sam and I did. If nothing else, it's definitely funny. And remember, tomorrow we're doing a subscriber giveaway for a Karambit knife. So tune into that as well. That's for our Case King of the Hill tournament tomorrow evening, featuring NIP, LDLC, and Na'Vi. Going to be a sick tournament with a lot of cool games coming up. And now, we're ready. Titan gets a start on the CT side, and Epsilon, they're on the Terrace side. Semler, who do you think is going to win here? You're the French representative.
I think Epsilon are going to win this pistol round. I think Epsilon should have a pretty damn good chance at winning this pistol round. They go for the perfect play. Straight up A rush, and Titan go for a B stack. It couldn't be worse for Titan right now.
No, it definitely couldn't. A really good exchange there. Existence could have definitely gone down without killing anyone, but the grenade throw was actually not at all bad. GMX taking some damage, and he's actually going to be facing Kenny here, but it's a long time wasted here. Kenny will get the kill, but the clock is ticking right now, and Titan need to move, and what? They just pick up everyone in the bomb site. Now SF is going to be alone, and Scream takes him down, and it's the most genius retake we've seen in a very long time. How did that happen?
Oh, Smiths. That was a cheeky play. That was really nice. I think that was all set up by, or kind of what gave it to Titan was Smith's move there from CT spawn.
Did you see the nade onto Shoxi?
Yeah, I did. But what Smith did was really cheeky. Like, the way he kind of just shut one of the Epsilon players in a corner with no room to escape.
So, I don't even know. I don't even think Epsilon did anything really wrong that round. Like, they picked the right bomb site, they got the bomb down, they got into some good post-plant positions, and then Titan just went crazy.
Yeah, that's fairly accurate assessment of what happened.
Good shots being put through here. Existence doing significant damage, but it's MBK to pick up the one, the two, and the third kill as well. Now he's looking for a fourth one, and SF is going to be the target of choice, and we're looking for an ace here from MBK, but they're not going to give it to him. Kiyoshima takes it away, but also getting body blocked a little bit by Kenny there. So that's a little bit of a miscommunication from Titan. I feel like that really shouldn't have happened. Really good kills coming in from Epsilon with those two, but they did buy armor, I think. So maybe it's not quite enough. Actually, why did they buy armor?
Well, everyone didn't buy armor.
All right.
So I think actually only Kiyoshima bought armor that round.
Yeah, that's what it seems like right now. They still have quite a bit of money on Epsilon's side, and they're even going for another round of eco here.
Yeah, I think they want the op on FXO as quickly as possible, because he didn't buy anything at all that previous round, so he's just already on 4k.
Smiths and NBK both have only got pistols this round. That's really interesting.
How do you like that, Vendetta? How angry does it make you?
Does not make me happy at all. Luckily for them, though, they have Kenny S there.
Yeah, Kenny looking good, and he's going to pick up a quad kill in this round. He's also at 5-0-0, so he's building up a bit of a bank on his own. Actually going to be able to drop the Smiths and pick up an AWP to face the one that FXO has. This, I think, is going to be... This could be the beginning of a pretty interesting battle between two of the best AWPers in France, it seems. If we could have, like, a three-way match and put Kaylee in here, it'd be really fun.
Please, right? Please. But look at this play from Titan coming into aggressively into A house. They push all the way in, they immediately lose existence, but then Scream picks up the frag, and that's really going to force Epsilon's hand. Smith's going for a mad spray on the A site, but he gets nothing for it.
There's no reason he really did that. That was a little bit weird, because he could have easily picked off the guy running out there. So maybe a bit of a mistake. Great grenade onto Scream, though. Very nice precision coming out here. MBK is going to flash his way into middle, almost takes down FXO, but DMX is there to help out. So this is actually looking pretty good for Epsilon. I think he can take this round. Titan coming up with a kill. That's Kenny, long range with the AWP. And we're back into a 2-on-1 now. Kenny, I'm not sure why Epsilon were facing him that much there.
They were hoping for the quick pickoff before they committed to the bomb site, and it doesn't really work too often to do those kinds of peek versus Kenny.
He's too quick. He's definitely too quick. And when he gets the position, is like from CT spawn, he's such a hard target to hit as well. Whereas if you're going with a rhythm like that, because there was a clear rhythm to how he was moving, Kenny's going to get the final frag just to put, you know, the period on that phrase to say, yes, this is my site. But when you have some kind of rhythm like that, Kenny, yes, he made it look easy for both of them.
And did they steal an AWP? I think they did.
Yeah, MBK picked up an AWP. I think that was FXCO soft.
That's really great. It's a really good start here, but remember Titan are on the more favorite side here. So it's not, yeah, it's bad for Epsilon, but it's not completely bad. They can definitely change this game around. There's a lot of money on Titan. That's obviously not so good. They're going to be walking down the underpass here. And we'll see what it's going to be here. Epsilon, last time I saw them on this map where they really went really bad, that was against Fnatic, and Fnatic actually just completely crushed them. So I'm hoping we won't see a similar performance from Epsilon. I'd like to see them sort of bounce back on this map.
Look at Kenny's position right now. He just jumped, so they heard that. FXO, is he going to get the drop on him, though? Kenny S will find FXO first. Kenny S predicting the boost up in the window, though, gets rewarded with a frag. And Existence is here to support him as well with that rifle. They are going to be going for the A split, however. Or at least straight up through connector for Epsilon. Let's see if they can actually catch somebody off guard.
Existence looking in there. Does spot a couple of people. And right now, Titan is making sure they're not throwing too much away. This is really safe play from the CT side. But I'm a big fan of the way they're doing this right here. What do you think, Ben? Is this the right way of doing it?
Definitely. They're not interested in giving away any weapons at all and giving Epsilon a shot at actually winning this round. And there's no real reason for them to actually try to figure out what Epsilon is doing because Epsilon aren't committing to anything at all.
Flash onto short, and Smiths makes it look easy. Picks GMX out of the air. Scream is going to be here to support Kenny S. Shoxy just barely doesn't manage to pick up that AWP. He gets caught by Scream before he can close the distance, and now Kyoshima should get nailed, and he does. Scream even managing to save that AWP there, so... A near perfect round actually coming out from Titan.
Yeah, I'm such an admirer of the way they play that so slowly, because this is it. This kind of play, I think, from Titan should be the standard play from almost all top teams, right? But for some reason, a lot of them seem to make mistakes where they actually end up getting picked off and lose a lot of anti-eco rounds, and that's a real shame. Now, there's still the double up coming out here from Titan, but there's also one on FXGO, and he's right there in the middle, peeking against Kenny, and Kenny's not going to want to challenge twice.
I think the real beauty of that last round, though, was the fact that the Titans saw what Epsilon were going to do before Epsilon were even doing it. They gave up Window, they gave up CPL, they fell back into CT, and Epsilon, I'm sure they felt so sneaky going into Window, looking like they were going to get a flank on somebody, and then nobody was there for them to pick up gun off of.
Look at this here.
That was
Look at Existence.
Really sick.
He's being boosted up in this corner. If ever they come for the A ramp right here, no one. Kyushima is seconds away from dying. He is never going to be checking this corner. Walks right in here, Existence is down, and Kyoshima, they're walking right underneath each other, and he spots the gun barrel. He's waiting for more. Existence is playing this so smartly. He's finally going to pick up the kill, but if there had been more people, Existence was ready to kill all of them.
That was so sick. And Existence is still holding there. He's not worried at all. He's still looking for the guys that are going to be coming in. NBK, towards short, has had the worst luck possible this round. Smiths gets caught in the B apartments. NBK now caught in a bit of a tight spot.
Pick up the one, he's going to get headshot, but Kenny's here. Picks up one kill, gets a second one, and that seals the deal. Even with this great flank coming up from GMX, if the bomb had been down, GMX's flank here would have been worth its weight in gold, but now it's going to be too late. He's going to go down, and that will be a sixth round with no bomb plant here for Epsilon. Now, they can and will still force it up in this round, but they're not having much luck here in the beginning of this half.
Now, I don't know if you caught that, but that was like the worst luck for NBK twice running, because each time he unscoped just as a target came around the corner.
I caught the second time.
Yeah, the first time was the same thing. I think it was Kyoshima pushing him in B apartments, but he reloaded as Kyoshima came around the corner. So that time he got screwed, and then the second time on short, just like no luck for NBK that round.
So Vendetta, they've lost a couple of rounds. Now they're back to a standard A push. What do you think about that idea? Obviously going to be the smokes and the flashes and everything here.
Not a shabby idea, and I guess it all comes down to execution, because they were able to get the bomb site as well in the pistol round, but they weren't able to do anything at all versus the retake of Titan. And it seems like Titan are perfectly content with just letting Epsilon have that bomb site as well, so...
I think they failed that smoke. I think that smoke that's on short right now was meant to go all the way over to connectors. Now they left solo Kenny in here, and he's got an opening, he's going to pick up GMX. I think that one smoke could cost Epsilon a lot in this round. They're trying to push in here, but now Titan know what's happening. The rotation is in effect. Kenny's going to pick up a double kill, and now a triple kill, and Kenny finally goes down, but he has already wreaked havoc on the Epsilon lineup. FXO peeks in, and a good headshot comes through. He's now in a 2-on-3, now 1-on-3 here for SF, and he's going to get picked apart. Did you see that smoke?
Which one? The one towards spawn, or yeah, the one that was supposed to...
The one for the stairwell. That hit just, like, you know, 30 centimeters to the right, and it hit the wall and bounced back down towards the ramp. I think that smoke just ruined it.
Well, it might have delayed their push a tiny bit, but I think Kenny has kind of bravely walking through that smoke, and CT spawned and more for them, because he, even though they would have gotten that smoke correctly placed, Kenny S would have still been able to pick off people the way he did.
No, but I think Kenny actually walked through from connector.
No, Kenny came from the spawn.
Alright, fair enough. But anyway, anyone else who would have been coming through that way would have been able to walk in clearly into the site, so either way, it's a really not a good mistake to make from Epsilon, but I guess maybe it didn't cost them the round, maybe it was just Kenny going crazy. 7-0, Smiths with some really sick timing. DMX was just looking, and now when he comes back, Smiths is looking instead. So that's just, I mean, now you're also just talking about basic misfortune coming in here from Epsilon, I feel like.
It's looking really rough for them at this point. Kenny S is alive in CPL, misses a shot uncharacteristically there. NVK taking a bit of a fight with FXO, not going to be able to pick up a kill either. FXO is going to be able to flank his teammate now. NVK stops him in the nick of time.
Existence fired the last few bullets through the wooden panel right into Shoxy's face. SF is in the smoke, and he's got to be careful he doesn't actually get knifed here. Kenny will take him down. That spray through the wooden panel was brilliant by Existence. That was, I don't know what to say. Kenny's at 15-1-2, and we've been talking the last couple of days about what happens if FXO, what happens if Shoxy, what happens if Christy or Alu goes crazy, but, I mean, Kenny has a Kenny level all on his own as well, and we're seeing it right here.
We really are, but it's really disheartening to see Epsilon play the way they do, because it doesn't seem like they have a really solid plan as to what they want to do each round, and they're just kind of running into the gauntlet that is Titan at this point.
And they're back to echoing.
Yeah, like, what's the idea behind GMX pushing up right there, all by himself? And, I'm not really too happy. Oh, that's...
That was sick!
That was sick. Yeah.
I want Shoxy to stop right now and just type hashtag worth in the chat, like in all chat, because that was definitely... Whatever else happened, Shoxy also did that, and we will remember it at least until the game is over. Shoxy's now walking up through the edge of the smoke here, and I think it's Smith's on the other side.
Oh, that makes it all worth it.
Oh yeah, it really does, man. That is so sick. Kenny, yes, he puts an end to Shoxy's reign of terror. No wall banging necessary. Kenny's still waiting for that last man. The bomb has been dropped at the end of the apartment, so there really is no choice for Epsilon. They have to come through here eventually, and Kenny knows it. So, we may have the flank, the potential flank from Kiyoshima through window, but that's pretty much all Epsilon have going for them right now.
Yeah, Kiyoshima and Existence is looking right at him. He's not got a lot of health, actually, so one click here is going to be enough for Kiyoshima to get the kill. Even if it's a body shot, it will be doing enough damage, but he can't really find it. Kenny goes down to SF, and 2-on-3 with just 10 seconds left. It's really not a lot of time here, but Epsilon are at least doing some damage, and I guess that is also has a sort of a quality on its own here. Taking some money away, but speaking of money, Vendetta, how much money have they got on Titan side? I mean, look at this.
Yeah, they're pretty much the Swiss bank at this point.
Yeah, Kenny S buys up fully.
Norwegian bank.
No, they're the Norwegian oil fund.
Exactly. That's what's going on, alright.
Well, when you can buy an op, get full bot, and still have 9k in the bank, that's a pretty comfortable position for you to be in, on any side. That's pretty satisfying.
Oh man. So another thing that's going on here is that FXO is not getting a lot of entry frags. In fact, he's only got 2 kills here in the first 10 rounds, whereas, well, so same for Kiyoshima and GMX. So really, maybe that's just what it comes down to here. Epsilon are not actually killing a lot of Titan players at the moment.
Yeah, they're basically just getting shut down instantly every round. They haven't really done anything at all. I think the best round they had was their pistol round, and that got shut down pretty brutally.
Existence with a good kill there. Kenny is going to be taking down FXO, and Smith's right across the corner here is going to be going down to Shoxy. So now it's Kiyoshima and Shoxy left 2-on-4. See if they can bring it back. Somehow it's a really good shot from Kiyoshima, and a second one as well. Nice aim coming out from Kiyoshima. That's really the sort of play they need now. But they still have to deal with Kenny, and it's not so easy. He's going to walk up and take down Kiyoshima, leaving Shoxy alone in a 1-on-2. The bomb only just going down, so Titan have so much time, and it's going to be NBK going down next. Now a 1-on-1. Kenny versus Shoxy, the old rivals.
And there you have it. Shoxy playing it perfectly. In fact, even going to be able to save up that AWP.
That's a big round.
That was perfect. That was really nicely done. And, I mean, that round, Epsilon O, this one round on the board, pretty much to Kiyoshima. Because the shot that he got on screen was disgusting. The one he gets on the guy coming out from shadow is pretty damn good too, but the shot he got originally on Scream, who was holding in Get Right, just that little peek pre-fire, yeah. And he just knows where Scream is going to be, that was just really sick. Look, that probably got that. Him fired up for the rest of it.
Kenny body blocks the smoke coming in from seats from Terry spawn. Just a tiny detail, but that means, look at Shoxi, he thought that window was going to be smoked off. If Kenny hit that shot, it would have been because of his own brilliance. It's such a tiny detail, but man, I wish he would have got that shot. That was definitely well-deserved. It's... yeah, just a tiny moment of real beauty here in the game. Existence pushed up into apartments. Kiyoshima is going to be walking right into him and actually doesn't go down, only takes a little bit of damage.
This is throwing Titan for a loop, though. They clearly think that this was going to be a B play. The rotation came out, and instead, Epsilon managed to sneak two guys, soon to be three, up onto this A side. Existence is the only man up in A apartments. He's got support from Scream, who's in CT, but the rotation is going to have to come through here.
The one thing, though, is
that FXO cannot die.
Existence, did he not hear that shot? Shoxi just fired at Existence. Existence is just ignoring it. That was a big mistake coming out. I'm not sure. Actually, this could have made a really big difference. Did you see that, Ven?
Yeah, and actually, that would have been made all the difference, really, because if Existence is alive up in apartments, that takes so much focus away from everyone else on Titan. And it's going to be really hard for Epsilon to actually get the bomb down safely with the other Titan members kind of closing in on towards the bomb site.
I don't know. Do you think... that was good, but putting FXO alone through CPL when there's guys from Titan rotating through, he's alone with the bomb. If Titan get that kill on him as he's trying to cross right here at this gap where Kenny S went through, all of a sudden life gets pretty difficult for Epsilon.
Oh, yeah. That would have been around easily.
Oh, one more grenade at the top of mid here, and FXO is going to be gone, but coming up from underpass, it's going to be two people quick, and they actually sandwich the Titan players in, so Epsilon are now starting to bring it back a little bit. Good wall bang coming through. Smith's here, should be able to get a kill on FZF, but he's just immortal, he's not going down, and now MBK's alone, and he will be dropped. Kiyoshima again with a sick aim coming out, and this round could have pretty much gone either way, but it's very good to see Epsilon actually winning the rounds here, especially because... they're going to force an eco, I think, on Titan. They have money to buy on three players, but that's about it. Maybe really only two. They're going to do it.
They go for the force. Yeah. I would have been surprised if they didn't go for the force there, actually. Their money was way, way all over the place, but they still have enough to get firepower on everybody. What the answer is going to be here for Epsilon, they must think that this is an eco round out of Titan. They're about to run right into guns.
Scream goes down, tries to make a run for Shadows now. Good pickup from Kenny, goes for a second one here. Needs to land the shot and this kill on SF really quickly. Shoxi's coming in with a headshot on Smith, so this is a really big turnaround. Existence going to go down as well, and now things are looking even worse for Titan.
Oh, the nade doing minimal damage to Kenny. Not the end of the world, but there's still four members alive here for Epsilon. Everybody's so low. What is going on? Kenny S and NBK get two frags. Kenny S now looking towards Shoxi. He knows that he's in Shadow. Look at him, he's baiting out that kill, but is Shoxi gonna get it? First, Shoxi with the spray! Does it.
That was a complete failure from Kenny. I mean...
it really was. That was an easy kill. I actually thought Kenny S should have had that round.
Yeah, I agree. The initial play from MBK was so cool, because he actually just jumped down towards Get Right and chased down the one player. That was a very, very nice play from MBK. But Kenny should have at least killed Shoxi. Like, that was basically the most trivial kill. So maybe some nerves coming into play here as they've lost four rounds in a row, because that was very weird. Well,
right now, I mean, we have the eco from Titan. This is the thing, it has been forced on them. And they're still in a good position to finish this half. It's going to come down to the 15th round, pretty much. Epsilon with five rounds is good, but if they can get six rounds, that would be a terrific end to this half. The big thing here is, I think it's just that Epsilon, all of a sudden, thanks to Kiyoshima, I think, starting to land some sick shots, that gave him some confidence back, and then they were able to actually get those kills on Titan that they couldn't seem to get in the first, what, nine rounds of the half.
Yeah, what's worrying for Epsilon, though, is that more than anything, this has been Shoxi and Kiyoshima willing those four rounds for Epsilon. I wouldn't say it's been a team effort per se, because it's in both teams, you know, slugging it out, and Kiyoshima and Shoxi kind of saving Epsilon in the end. And that's not really something you can rely on going into the second half.
Scream, a lot of targets, not going to get anyone here. Obviously, CSET 75 in hand is very nearly impossible. Good long range shot coming in, almost takes down GMX, in fact, but with the bomb down, This is going to be at least 9-5, and the question is, you said, Semler, is it going to be all the way up to 9-6?
Yeah, if Epsilon can get 6 rounds, that would be terrific for them, really. Like, that would be such a big recovery. Even 5 rounds is huge after how this first half was going at the beginning of it. NBK getting caught, good rotation in from SF, doesn't manage to let NBK actually pick up that gun and get out of there with it. So really, didn't have that big of an impact, actually. I thought it would actually affect Titan's economy a bit more, but that round of eco really did it for them. They can fully invest in this 15th round.
Yeah, 20 kills on Kenny, 14 on MBK, and then it sort of drops off a bit from there. Scream Smith's and existence a little bit lower here. Kenny in the middle against FXO, and he's going to come out big. But as you said, FXO hasn't really been carrying. In fact, he's got 3 kills in total, so maybe it doesn't have a biggest impact as it would have in a different match here, because you're right, it's Kiyoshima and Shoxi they need to kill.
Yeah, Kiyoshima and... is really, I mean, and he is a guy that we've been seeing good performances actually from. I mean, he seems to really be able to step up. Smith, he has his trusty AWP, makes me happy to see that they're actually incorporating that in there, and they get something out of it as well. So now Titan are looking to be in a fantastic position here. 15th round and 2 guys up.
Yeah, it's really good. But those 5 rounds that they lost in a row in the middle or the end of this half here could... that could really come back to bite them. I'm wondering if they're going to be ready for Existence peeking right down here. Kiyoshima's going to come around the corner. He can see the gun barrel, and Existence doesn't want to challenge. In fact, he's going to smoke it off to try and buy even more time here.
Yeah, this is really burning clock off. I mean, time off the clock. 40 seconds left here for Epsilon to start making a call, and now they've been denied pit. GMX is managing to sneak up, though, and he does get the flank on Existence. Kenny not going to get the shot, but Smiths will.
It's a really brave effort from GMX. I mean, he really put a lot into that, and that could have paid off even more than it did. So I'm a little bit sorry that didn't work out, because that was actually a very cool position coming out from the Frenchman. Shoxi is going to go down to Scream, and Kiyoshima will fall really hard 2-on-4 at the end here for them. Really not much they could do there. 10-5 for the first half, and I mean, we've seen a little bit of everything. I'm glad to see that Epsilon were able to recover a little bit, but I also think we saw a couple of moments from Titan when it seemed like all the kinks weren't completely ironed out, but still, I think a much better performance from them than it has been in the past. You know, maybe. So that's good. That's both good and bad, I think. Here.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of similar to what we saw in the Case King tournament, isn't it? Because what we saw on Mirage was Titan going, or Naughty starting off on an 8-0 run, and then Titan going off on an 8-0 run before Naughty went on their second 8-0 run, ending the match at 16-8, but still. What I'm hoping for is that Titan are not doing the same thing again, that they can consistently continue playing well over the course of the game, and that it's not just one big run and that's everything they have to give.
Now, that'd be a real shame if that happens. Well, hopefully it isn't. We are going to get the second half starting off right away here, guys. So, Titan versus Epsilon. Best of one game. Second half is coming up, and you're at Room on Fire again. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hope you guys are enjoying your evening. It's going to be a lot more coming up. Of course, after this, we have NIP and Titan playing each other. That's going to be a really sick game. So, definitely look forward to that. And I hope you guys will follow and subscribe to the channel. It helps us out a lot if you click that follow button. And a big thanks to the subscribers. And remember, tomorrow, we're going to be giving away a Karambit knife to the subscriber team. Some lucky winner is going to get it. But now, the rush is on. Great flash. SF goes down inside the bombsite. GMX is going to need backup and a lot of it, and really quickly. He's going to pick up one, then he goes down. Still no bomb plant here, and Titan are actually fighting before they put down the bomb.
Yeah, they want dominance, and they get it. I mean, now it's a 1-on-3. Shoxi is alone. He's going to try and sneak his way out from kitchen, but there's a man watching the angle, and he gets spotted down to 5 HP. Scream catches him off guard, and that is Titan securing that pistol round. Titan... once again, off to a terrific start at the beginning of this half, picking up that pistol right there. They only need 5 more rounds in this half, and Epsilon are so far away at this point.
I was, before I did my whole long rant of introduction, I was going to say, I feel like this pistol round is different between us having a close and interesting game, and maybe it being a little bit one-sided, because now it comes down to the fourth round. MBK up here might actually get caught off. Really aggressive move coming out, but MBK has a sawn-off shotgun? Are you joking?
Oh, yeah, man. And you know why? Because the sawn off, the shots go through wood now. So, hey, if you're sneaking out from balcony, you think the guy's down there, you can put shots through and get him.
I suppose it's actually kind of cool, because even if they pick Kenny S off, it's not like they're going to be like, oh, yeah, great, we have a sawn off shotgun. Now we win the round.
It's true. I like that they back off as well. They don't want to feed him too much money either. I mean, hell, if another one of them dies, it's $1,800. He just got $900 with that Shoxi headshot, so... NBK's not going to be he's not going to be too disappointed so far with the performance of this shoddy. Now it seems like Titan are setting up for an A play as well. They've got two smokes, one of them on NBK, the other on Existence. And Epsilon are currently thinking that this is going to be a B play, despite the fact that GMX has snuck all the way up into B apartments. I'm really surprised at how late this rotation is coming in from Epsilon.
Good damage from Kiyoshima here. I mean, that's Existence and NBK almost both down, but they don't really have any grenades or anything to try and retake this with. But it doesn't matter when SF is landing the one, the two, and now finally they're going to take him down. Those were the two people that were low, so really good body shots coming out. And now it's down into a 2-on-3. Kiyoshima is going to get caught, and it will be all over. But actually, that went from being kind of a bad round from Epsilon to being a pretty respectable round.
Yeah, I think it's okay. It's kind of what you expect from an eco round, isn't it?
Yeah, so. You expect SF to get two freebies with a Deagle.
Well, yeah, you know, you do some damage, you don't expect to win the round, and it's not just a complete wash with what they invested. So I think it's completely okay. It's not like it's going to startle Epsilon at all.
And Shoxi gets revenge on NBK.
And that's a big kill, actually, because NBK finally invested into an AK, and that could be a scary pickup for Shoxi.
Especially because he's coming out to the middle, he's shooting through here. If he catches a headshot right through, that could actually be all it takes. He does only do a little bit of damage, and now up from the apartment here, I think Kenny needs to rush in. He has a pistol. Why is Kenny not the one sacrificing himself? He's actually just going to be shooting at long range here, and they do open up the bombsite quite a bit, but it's still a 3-on-3, and Shoxi's shown up as well. FXJ with a kill. Now Kenny gets the one, but he's alone, and I think Kenny waited way too long in that position.
Kenny's got two bullets as well. Kenny is good. But I don't know if he's that good. He's got two bullets in his CZ-75 and he's pinned down behind a corner. Can he find a way? Oh, and he messes up his flash as well.
So, the whole of the Epsilon team was focused on the entrance, the catwalk into the B bomb site. And Kenny could have broken that focus by jumping down, and all he would have lost if it didn't work, all he would have lost was a CZ-75. Instead, they lost like two rifles before Kenny decided to move in. I think that was actually a little bit of miscommunication coming out, I think, from Titan there.
Not really sure if it's miscommunication either. I think that's just Kenny being a bit too afraid, really. I don't think... I'm actually pretty sure that Existence probably screamed at him that, you know, this is our time to go.
You're on the front line, soldiers. If you don't go, I'll shoot you in the back myself. That kind of deal?
Yeah.
Probably. MBK charging in, gonna be the one shot almost to his teammate in just complete panic there. And actually, MBK will go down now. Scream gonna pick up Kiyoshima, but they certainly can't afford any team kills. This is an eco round, and somehow it's actually paying off in favor of Titan, in spite of it being Epsilon with the rifles. Almost SF is down as well. This is not what... They can't lose this round, Epsilon. This is huge for them. They must win this.
This would be so big. FXCO right around the corner. Scream is still alive on this site, however. Scream just dancing around the angle. Kenny S, no more. Kenny S will track FXO down, and Scream finishes off SF. This is so back and forth between these teams, even with Smiths, I guess, mistaking NBK for a CT coming through that smoker connector and getting rid of him. Titan actually managed to hold on to that site.
Well, NBK almost shot Smiths, and then Smith shot Kenny instead, or NBK, so I don't really know what happened. It was madness. Now, they had money for two orbs, and they bought two orbs, and I don't know about this one, Vendetta. I mean, this seems like it's either this round or it's not going to happen at all.
Yeah, this is now or never. This is the Hail Mary buy from Epsilon. And it might as well work. Shoxi is definitely capable with the AWP, and so is FX.
I'm curious if this is... I mean, for a Hail Mary round, this is actually pretty cool. If they can get the right read and get into position, SF is going to be scouting out B apartments. Kenny is waiting here. No AWP for Kenny, only an AK, and he misses his shot. He has to be careful not to take a step too far into FXO, and there you go. FXO gets the first kill. GMX sneaking out on a short point blank with the dig.
And they finally they take him down. It's going to be another kill coming in here. Kiyoshima goes down 3-on-3, but up in this bomb site, Shoxi has a great position, but oh, he goes down. One dig from NBK. That was the position that held the bombsite. Now FXJO has to come up like the wizard he is and get a bunch of kills here. They smoke him off, but that doesn't stop him. He's going to go full man mode. Takes down one, shoots through the smoke, not going to connect with a shot. NBK and Scream just has to hold tight and wait and see if they can force him in here somehow.
No, they're going to try and burn this clock. There's no kit on Epsilon either. Something to keep in mind here. SF spots out by NBK, but NBK with a great shot at that AWP picks up the first, and now FXJO, he just doesn't have the time. No kit, and still two guys alive. If Titan play this right, FXO is not getting onto this site anytime soon.
Oh, he has to save now.
He's going to pick off MBK, which is good, but what are they saying here? What are they saying, Semler? Translate.
So you got revenge for the B wall, huh? And MBK is like, yeah, one for one.
Well, one for one is something we definitely enjoy on this channel. That's become our motto, inadvertently, admittedly, but, you know, it sticks somehow.
That reminds me, there was a funny line at the after the knife round where Shoxy went for, like, a jumping kill and actually picked off Scream. And he was laughing about it, you know, during that knife round, and Scream just calls him a weasel. I got a good little giggle there.
What the hell? Well, these guys are obviously good. It's fun to see the banter as well. The good pick off here up in the apartments. Kenny with the one, and then now a Scream picking off one more kill. So it's a 5-on-3, and Epsilon. Yeah, they went for the Hail Mary, but it didn't work out the way they planned.
Well, GMX knows where Existence is mid. Existence sitting in Delpan. It doesn't help GMX, though. And no. Nothing is going to work for Epsilon here. Scream just going to work.
Yeah, not a lot of things going Epsilon's way, and it looks like that little spurt that Kyushima and Shoxi gave them was all they had to give this game. And it's a shame, because you can see FXO has picked up some frags here on the CT side, and so has SF. And it's a shame that they couldn't all put that, I guess, their peak performance of the game into, you know, at the same time, because that could have easily led to quite a few rounds in the first half.
Yeah, agreed.
It's been a strange day for Epsilon overall, but I don't know. I'm just so much looking forward to seeing this Epsilon team on LAN once again, because they did take out Hellraisers on LAN for DreamHack Valencia, so they definitely had something, and that was with Mistu on the lineup. Now they have FXO, so I still think we can see a lot of great stuff coming out, but now the clock is running really late here. Not in the round, but just overall for Epsilon. They don't have a lot of life left in them here. It's 15-6. And they are one... Well, actually, no. They're going to keep picking up MBK, so they're a man up right now. GMX going to take down Smiths. What a great turnaround.
GMX is playing out of his mind right now. Absolutely out of his mind. He gets a third frag, and he gets the fourth. Well, there you go, Ben. I mean, it really does come in, you know, fits and bursts. But GMX, that round was sick.
That was a really solid round from him. And actually surprising that Existence got caught off guard, because it seemed like from the get-go that he knew that GMX was an underpass. He kind of lobbed a nade right in his face at the start of the round, and after that, just seemed to forget about him. I guess he kind of assumed that GMX would run away after that nade, but kudos to GMX for saving that round for Epsilon.
Find out. Existence going to be walking up, solely trying to see if he can flank in here, and he's going to find SF, which is a big problem for Epsilon. Now they actually lose control of the B-bomb site, but the worst thing is they're getting backstabbed by NBK. If they all rotate too quickly, he's going to be there to help out. No, he gets spotted, but still! Quandik from long range. A little bit of a body shot first. FXO, the only one on the bomb site, misses the shot on Kenny. Kenny misses in return, and now FXO goes down. Scream with the headshot, and this is game, guys. There's no chance for Choxy and GMX to come back in this, I think.
Yeah, they do manage to pick up NBK. Fittingly, it's Shoxy who finds that kill, so I'm sure there's going to be a little bit more smack talk at the end once GG is called, but this is a 2-on-4 retake. Shoxy and GMX, they've both got full HP. If they can just find the shots fast enough here, but Titan have had all the time in the world to set up with the afterplant positions, they should be able to handle whatever Epsilon throw at them, because Epsilon, no more nades to make it happen. It's all down to the rifle work, and Shoxy gets one, Shoxy with two, but they know where he is. He's coming up on short, he picks off Existence, and it's Smiths versus Shoxy, and Shoxy's got four frags. Is this the ace? Is this real life? Ah! It was a dream. Smiths ruins it all.
I mean, Shoxy is such a terrifying beast when he gets like this. It's a real shame he couldn't finish it. But even if he got the kill, I'm not sure there would have been enough time. But still, really, really sick at the end there, man. That was something. 16-7 is the scoreline. And now...